He's going to talk to us about the making and the history of the white man. Brother Bobby, how you doing this evening?
How you doing?
Okay.
Everything's cool.
Okay. So what can you tell us, you know, that maybe we may say that we already know or we don't know, that you can enlighten us on about the making of this white man?
Well, back in 1993, I did a tape called Human Artificial. And I did it in a lecture format, so I pretty much stuck to the main course of trying to explain the origin of the European based on the historical documents. I put out this particular pamphlet a year later in 1994, called The Human Artificials, and it went around the country, and also it's called Comedic and Ancient Documents of the Living Devil. And it was a real popular piece. I mean, people Xeroxed it till the graphics broke up. But what I was trying to do, this book was a consortium of different fragments from ancient and modern people dealing with the research of this European being created. Are made, in so many words, based on genetic engineering. And so, since 1994, I've gotten tons and tons of other research, so much until if I was to put it in a book, it would take up about two of these books. That's how much information. But we don't have that much time. The information we have covered before, but what I want to do is to give an update or revisit this particular material from 1994 and put some new research down. In the school of academia and Western education, but if this in basically a good structure for education or academia period is, in academia you go by two types of systems, two types of ways of looking at things. Number one, if you want to get to the truth, the first thing you have is anthropological or archaeological evidence or some type of scriptorial or some type of ancient fragments based on, that would also be archaeology, where we talk about papyruses and rare books and rare artifacts that would actually literally tell the story of what are you trying to look for. And this would actually be the basis of the truth. Now, you can have a theory, and a theory could be the basis on what you might say, give a synopsis of what you are trying to postulate when it comes to the origin of something, trying to get close to the meaning. And that theory can be viable, it can be substantial to a certain degree until archaeological and anthropological evidence comes into play. So, now dealing with the history of the European, we have several theories. Well, the white boy just decided he just don't want to deal with it at all. You know what I mean? He analyzes things down to the teeth. But somehow when it comes to the origin of himself, and when we ask this question, well, if the black man was the original person, which Mead tells you, Mendel, Mead, and different other people, and all types of archaeological finds, late 1800s, early 1900s, late 20th century, all types of archaeological finds, including the, what's that, Newsweek magazine, 1987? Or 88, I think it was 1988 might have been, and where they actually showed the two black people in the Garden of Eden, mm-hmm. A Jericho version, but still yet, this is the basic fact that most humans now understand that civilization started in Africa. But all of a sudden the European, all of a sudden he has a way to just basically become ignorant. Whereas when we ask this question, well, if the origin came from Africa, where the hell did you come from? Because you being the doggone opposite of that origin. You see what I'm saying? In color, prototype, you know what I'm saying? Phenotype, strength, any kind of thing across the board. Well, where did you come from? And all of a sudden, they never entertained the question. Few black scholars tried to entertain the question, but they went based on a theory. Sheikh Anta Diop, Dr. Charles Finch. They went on a theory of climate adaptability. But it's only a theory. And it stands as a theory until you find anthropological and archaeological evidence. Well, they've always had it, but what I did was I combinated all of this particular stuff 7 or 8 years ago, and we got to the bottom of this. And so, but people still don't want to deal with it. People still want to deal with it. Some people say, well, what difference does it make? Well, it makes all the difference in the world if you have a hybrid species running civilization. Then, if you have problems in the world as indigenous people, you could pretty much say that in your lifetime, you should never feel comfortable with a hybrid species that has shown you forms of inhumanity.
So are you saying this European, this Caucasian is a hybrid of sorts?
A hybrid. I don't want to say mutation, because mutation or mutant is a natural phenomenon in nature. It might be a 1/1,000,000th of a chance, but it's still natural. You see what I'm saying? It might be a freak where you have a mutation after so many thousands and thousands of cycles. You have a mutation in anything, but nevertheless, nature does mutate. You see what I'm saying? The earth does have forms of mutations. You see, they go on all the time. So we don't want to call him a mutant. We want to call him a hybrid. A hybrid is a deliberate genetic concoction or deliberate experiment. You see, or a hybrid can be a mistake, but not a form of nature, because most mutations in nature, although they are very rare, they don't occur to create a whole race of mutations.
You know, over the years in the conscious community, we've always referred to them as mutants.
Mm-hmm.
You're shedding the light on a new science,
right?
The hybrid information.
Hybrid, which we're talking about mock. A mock is a copy of the original. It's a knockoff of the original. This is a knockoff Breitling of the original. You know, this is a $6,000 watch in its original state, $39 in Canal Street, Manhattan, New York. That's a knockoff watch. There's a difference. You see, there's a hybrid state, and we need to make this very clear. What we're talking about here is a immigrant human. An immigrant human, something that migrates in, and as the Holy Kabbalah, A.E. Waite's Holy Kabbalah says, it is a, how does he put it, an intruder, something that is not there in the beginning, that is intruding and perpetrating a fraud as a human. The fact of the matter that it was created outside of the general civilization of humanity, of ancient civilization of humanity, when it did show up, people took it as another strain of a race. You see what I'm saying? Another strain of humanity, or what you would call a different aspect of humanity. All because its incubation period was secret. You see? Was secret. And so when people saw it thousands of years later, they automatically just thought it was a form of humanity. And as a result, this has been the mistake of indigenous people around the world, because number one, our nature is that to accept. We accept everything.